AI is replacing human tasks.
Well, AI is here.
Trustworthy AI.
Uses artificial intelligence.
Artificial intelligence is real intelligence, and sometimes it can be better than human intelligence.
It's everywhere nowadays, right? You can find it in the places you would expect, like computers and cell phones, but it's also found in places you might not, like your refrigerator, thermostat, and even your vacuum. Artificial intelligence is the hot topic in many circles, from Silicon Valley to Washington, D.C. So what is the future of AI? In 1950, Alan Turing wrote a paper called Computing, Machinery, and Intelligence that introduced a test to see if a machine could behave intelligently like a human. 75 years later, the promise of today's computer AI systems is so expansive that we can't possibly discuss them all in this video. But no matter the application, questions remain like, can we develop safe, responsible, and accurate artificial intelligence? There have been several studies examining people's trust in AI, and they indicate that while there is a recognition of AI's potential benefits, there are significant concerns. How we address these concerns is crucial for building and maintaining public trust in AI systems. I've recently sat down with Tess DeBlanc-Knowles, who is the Special Assistant on AI to the U.S. National Science Foundation's Director.
What are some of the challenges with educating the public about AI?
From my perspective, the challenges in educating the public around AI really come down to hype. And I think that kind of goes in both ways. Hype around what today's AI systems can do, which I think is often overstated or kind of perceived to be more advanced than they actually are, as well as hype in the terms of really the fear around future systems and the impact that they can have on jobs or humanity. And I think moving forward, kind of both of those extremes point to the fact that we need to kind of build AI literacy really across the country and at all different ages.
Understanding what artificial intelligence is and isn't is tricky, since there is no formal definition. Broadly speaking, it is a branch of computer science focused on creating systems capable of performing tasks that typically require human intelligence. Tasks like learning, problem solving, and language understanding. It aims to develop algorithms and models that allow machines to interpret data, learn from it, and make decisions or predictions based on that learning. This is where the massive potential lies. The opportunity for increased computational efficiencies could change scientific processes across the board, especially in nationally critical areas like materials design.
And AI in the kind of material design and discovery context is one of these great examples of really the potential of AI to accelerate the discovery and innovation cycle. A machine learning model can help a researcher predict essentially the qualities of the material that they're looking for. And so a model is narrowing down that zone of promising experiments for the researchers.
Materials for semiconductors, the technology behind computer chips, is an area where scientists and engineers are looking for new and more efficient materials. NSF-supported engineers have developed a new material that may extend the life of our electronic devices while lowering the energy consumption. It's a high crystallinity topological semi-metal where electrons behave differently. The material has the potential to create devices that rely on the spin of electrons instead of their electrical charge like traditional semiconductors. AI could be joining your local weather team too. It has the potential to help us transform huge amounts of weather data, leading to better severe weather predictions.
The ability to better predict it and better understand it is really going to make us improve our climate resiliency and save lives. And that's what excites me the most, is that we can actually really make a difference with AI to actually save people's lives.
And that is where AI in severe weather situations could have the biggest impact. With more time to prepare, emergency managers can get disaster response resources in place faster. Forecasters can communicate to the public more accurately, so people can take the necessary safety precautions in advance.
We want to be able to create novel AI techniques that are going to be trustworthy in high impact situations. And so That can include weather, that can include climate. We've actually recently initiated a collaboration with somebody in medicine because it turns out a lot of things that we're talking about exist in medicine as well. So for example, when the AI model is giving you a prediction, you know, how do you communicate the uncertainty of that model? It turns out that those kinds of issues really matter to doctors as well. I want to be able to better understand what it means to trust the AI and what we need to do to change our AI, to change our communication, to improve our ability to use the AI to really make better decisions as a whole.
Speaking of the medical field, that was also something I talked to Tess DeBlanc-Knowles about, developing new therapeutics in the span of months rather than decades.
And this is another case like new materials where there's a lot of promise there for the application of AI to really accelerate this process of drug discovery and development of new therapeutics. We also see scenarios where researchers are using AI to model how molecules interact with the body.
Parkinson's disease, for example, is a neurodegenerative disorder that impacts almost 7 million Americans. Using a simple webcam, NSF-supported researchers have developed a new AI tool to rate the severity of a patient's Parkinson's, making it easier for a doctor to develop a personalized therapy plan. And while expert neurologists perform slightly better, the AI model did outperform primary care physicians. This model has big implications for patients that have difficulty traveling to appointments or even accessing neurologists. We've really only scratched the surface of how we can leverage artificial intelligence. And because of this, the National Science Foundation has led the creation of national AI research institutes spread across the country since 2020. They cover a range of topics from agriculture, forestry and education to cybersecurity, machine learning, and edge computing. There's AI being tested to differentiate fingerprints at crime scenes more accurately, an NSF-supported project. There's research using AI to identify plagiarism from AI language models, another NSF-supported project. Tracking drug trafficking signatures online, identifying illnesses before symptoms show, and autonomous labs that create, plan, and conduct experiments, all with NSF investments. AI feels like it's everywhere, and it's coming to more places. Our trust in it will have to be earned, but the work is underway to ensure we can.